Hi, in this chapter, we'll create a development build that can run on iOS devices using EAS build. So let's get started. To be able to run applications on an iOS physical device, you're going to need an Apple developer account. This is required to access necessary credentials for signing your application, as each build needs to be signed to verify that the app comes by a trusted source. Don't worry, because EAS build manages these credentials for us, so we don't have to worry about that. The other prerequisite is going to be having a developer mode activated on your iOS device. So on the right, I have my iPhone 13 Pro, and we're going to be testing this application on this iPhone. So I already have an Apple developer account and I already have an iPhone. So let's move on to the next step, which is going to be the provisional profile. So to initiate the development on iOS, we need to register the device. We can do that using EAS CLI. So let's create a new device by running this command in our project. So I'll go to my project, stop the terminal, and then run this command, EAS device create, and hit enter. So as you can see, this command lets you register Apple devices like iPads, iPhones, and Macs. So in this case, this is telling me you are inside a project directory. Do you want to continue with your account? And I'll say yes. This is going to ask me for my Apple credentials. So I'll just go ahead and use my Apple developer account and then select the team that I want to use. Then this is asking me, how would you like to register your devices? So this is actually a very important step because you might want to register devices from coworkers or from clients. And in that case, you would want to use a website. In this case, the website generates a registration URL to open on your devices. Also, you can use the developer portal, which imports devices already registered in the Apple developer portal. Input allows you to type the UUID IDs. This is an advanced option. So if you prefer to use the website, just go ahead and use the website. And so that you can send the link to anyone that you want them to register their devices. But in this case, I will use my UUID ID. So this is the advanced option kind of, because this is asking me for the UUID ID and I need to have this number, right? So what we can do, because I have my iPhone connected to the computer, I can just go to the Finder and then select my iPhone on the left, as you can see here. And then as you can see, this is the name of my iPhone. I can change the name and I can see some information. But if you click on the model of the phone, you'll find the serial number. And then if you click again, you'll find the UUID ID. So from here, you can do right click and then copy UUID ID. Then come to the CLI and paste this in here. Device name, I'll say iPhone 13 Pro. And hit enter. Then it's asking me the device class. In this case, it's an iPhone. And then is this what you want to register? So just to double check, everything looks right, my team and my device. So I'll just go ahead and say yes. Okay, and this is registering the device. Do you want to register a new one? I'll say no. Cool, so at this point, we have registered this device. So let's go back to the guide. In the guide, actually, you can see an example selecting website, which is going to take you to this link. And then you have to download the profile on that specific device and then install the profile. Once you do that, the device should be registered now to develop applications. So the next thing that we need to do is just create a new development build for iOS. So let's copy this command, go to the terminal, clear, and run this again. If you notice, it's the same thing that we did before, but in this case, we are specifying the platform to be iOS and hit enter. And this is going to kick off the build. Now it's asking me as well for the bundle identifier, similar to what we did with Android, with the package, we're gonna be using the same string. So I'll just go ahead and hit enter. As you notice, the bundle identifier has been added in here. And then also it's asking me to log in my Apple developer account. So just let's go ahead and use my account. Let's hit enter, select my team. Now in this case, I'm gonna be reutilizing my distribution certificate. If you don't have one, EAS CLI is going to create one for you. Now in this case, I can see that I have 3 registered iPhones. So in this case, I have iPhone 15 Pro, which is the one that we just added. So actually I had it before, as you can see, it's the same UUID under a different name. I'll just select the new one. Yeah, actually I selected the 3 of them. I mean, 2 of them are duplicates, but yeah, anyways, this is going to create the build with the following information. And you can see that this has been uploaded to EAS and now it's starting the build. Okay guys, and the build is ready. It took roughly 10 minutes as well. And from here, it's just a matter of installing on the device. So you can open this using Orbit or just press the install and scan the QR code. So let me bring my device and I'll scan this and I'll open this link. This is going to prompt me to install and I'll say install. And if I go back, you can see that now it's installing the application there. And let's go back and check out that the server is running. Otherwise, this is going to fail. I'll say npx expo start. By the way, it was easier if I just had scanned this QR code, but anyways, it's the same thing. All right, so the server is running. Now, if I try to open my app, I'm going to get this alert that developer mode is required. So I'll press OK, and then we need to go to settings and scroll down all the way to privacy and security to activate the developer mode. And if I scroll down at the bottom, I can see now the developer mode. By the way, before I installed this application, I couldn't see the developer mode. So if you are not able to see it, just go ahead and install the app and then you'll be able to see the developer mode option. And then I'll turn this on and I need to restart. So let's wait a second. Okay, so here's my screen again. And by the way, I got the alert. I couldn't show that on screen, but I saw this. So I had to press turn on and then enter my passcode. And now we are in this screen. So I'll just go ahead and select the app again. And let's see if this works. Okay, so one thing is that you need to sign in. So I'll just go ahead and log in on the top right. This is going to take me to Expo. I'll sign in, then enter my verification code. Verify, and now I can select the account that I want to use. In this case, I'll select Beto at Expo and then I can close this. Okay, so in this case, as you can see, I'm not able to see the server even though I enter my credentials. So what I'll do is just go to my camera and scan this QR code again and open. This is going to ask me if I want to allow permissions for my local network. And I guess this is why I couldn't see anything because I didn't get this alert before. So let's reload and now I'm able to load the application without any issues and I can start charging my friends for the bill. So let's say two friends is going to be 78. Now, the same thing, guys, we can go to the index and actually in this case, remove this test string and we are going to get the benefit of using live reloading on a development build. This is great for testing push notifications, payments, and stuff like that. So that's it for this chapter. We learned how to activate developer mode for iOS devices. We also learned how to create and add new devices to our developer account so that we can install builds. And we also learned how to use EAS to create a build in the cloud and then install it on real devices. So I hope you like this chapter. I hope you learned something new. Don't forget to give it a like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.